الله الرحمن الرحيم، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. The series of the traditions that we are presenting these days, Imam Sahib says that sometimes after reading the words of the tradition, sometimes when he has a chance to explain them, then sometimes one thing comes out of another thing, and then sometimes when he feels that he feels that he should confine himself, then he afterwards thinks that perhaps some explanation are rather lacking. So in this regard, Imam Sahib wishes to go back to the previous dars in which the treatment of neighbors was mentioned. So here Imam Sahib says that the neighbors that are mentioned here is something which is so incredible. The scenario that Islam presents in this regard is more than what we usually think. That is, we refer to those who live right next door to us on either side as being our neighbor, but Islam has expanded the our neighborhood to far more than that. In fact, we have been told that up to 40 homes around us are our neighbors, should be regarded as our neighbors, and good treatment of them is extremely important. And without any without any distinction of whether they are belong to our religious beliefs or not, we should treat them well. Imam Sahib says that it reminds him of an incident that there was an Ahmadi who had in his neighborhood. There was a Christian family, and the lady, that is the wife of one of the guy, passed away, and when he died, then perhaps they don't have the tradition of people coming one after the other to offer condolences. So that Ahmadi went to his Christian neighbor's house and knocked on the door and told him that this is what I've heard, is it true? And he said, yes, this is true. His wife had passed away. Then the Ahmadi neighbor went with his permission inside his house and sat with him and tried to comfort him and asked him how he was doing and told him some things, and then offered his help and at his time of worry, and told him that if he needs any food, etc., he should inform him. And he did all this accordance with the Islamic teachings, and he thus offered his condolences and treated him very well. And when he was returning, then the Christian person said something. He said that, I am sure that like you are treating me and you have offered your condolences, but if this had happened at the home of a Muslim neighbor, then I don't know if any Christian would go to their homes and offer such support as you have offered me. Of course, there might be some exceptions to this, but this is not a part of their religious teachings, which is something which is an amazing and peerless teaching that illustrates the greatness of Islamic teachings. The next tradition I'm supposed to present is Man kanat lahu untha wa lam ya'idha lam yusir waladahu yusir waladahu alayha Yani al-Zukura adkhalahu Allahu al-Jannata. This tradition translates as that the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that the person to whom is born a daughter and he does not bury her alive, and neither does he give precedence to his sons over that daughter, then Allah will make him enter heaven, will permit him to enter heaven. Here a couple of things are mentioned, and in actual fact every single word, every saying of the Holy Prophet ﷺ contains within it an ocean of meaning. The first thing that's mentioned is that in the olden days, in the era of ignorance, when in Arabian countries someone used to have a daughter, then he used to think it a source of embarrassment and a source of humiliation. And they, even if they were quiet in the beginning, they would be searching for an opportunity to bury her alive. And this happened in the time of the Holy Prophet ﷺ, when a companion said to the Holy Prophet ﷺ that the same thing happened to me as well, that he had a daughter and she was very pretty, but he wanted her to bury her alive because that was a custom in his tribe. And he related his story to the Holy Prophet ﷺ, and it's extremely horrific and very sad. He said that he kept searching for a chance, and she grew, and she grew up to be about 5 or 6 years old. And once he took her with her to a jungle, and dug a hole in the ground, and then he pushed his own daughter. Imam Sahib, just imagine that he did this. He pushed her own daughter into the pit, and he was, with weeping eyes, he was repeating the story, and he said that she threw him, and she kept asking him, "Daddy, Daddy, what are you doing?" But he was so harsh and hard-hearted that he kept throwing the soil over her, and until such time that she was buried beneath the soil, and her voice stopped coming. And when she looked up to the Holy Prophet ﷺ, his eyes were wet with tears as well. And he said that when you heard your daughter crying, did you have no mercy over him? Did you show him, did you have soft-heartedness in you, that you should have saved her? And then the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that if someone isn't merciful, mercy isn't shown to him. The Holy Prophet ﷺ mentioned this tradition that girls should in fact be treated equally to girls. They should be regarded, they should be seen equally, and they should be the same love should be shown to them, and no distinction should be made between sons and daughters, and they should not be given any precedence whatsoever over the boys should not be given any precedence over the girls. And in general also, if a home in which boys are not given precedence over girls, then the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that the dwellers of that home will be able to go to heaven. So Imam Sahib says that children are a blessing, and it is an obligation on all Muslims to treat boys and girls equally. In the second tradition, مَنْ سَرَّهُ يُحِبَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أَوْ يُحِبُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ فَلْ يَسْتُقْ حَدِيثَهُ إِذَا حَدَّثَهُ وَلْيُوَدِّ أَمَانَتَهُ إِذَا تُوْمِنَ وَلْيُحْسِنْ جَوَارَ مَنْ جَاوَرَ. These were the Arabic words of the tradition, and quite lengthy. Imam Sahib saying that let's look at the translation first before we go into the explanation. In this, the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that a person who desires that Allah and His Prophet, who wants to love the Holy Prophet ﷺ, and who wishes to love the Allah, and who wishes to earn their love. So the Holy Prophet ﷺ said, if anyone harbors his desire in his heart, that he wishes to love them, and he wishes them to love him as well. So what should he do if this is what he desires? The Holy Prophet ﷺ said that he should make sure that whenever he speaks, he must always speak the complete truth. Whatever he says, he should be true. It should be true. It should never be false. He should never get close to falsehood and words that cannot be misconstrued in any way. will lead to the nearness of Allah and the love of the nearness and the love of Allah. And then the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that if something is kept with him in trust, for example, if someone is going on a journey, he keeps his trust with someone, but it might be wealth or journey, etc. So that trust should be given back according to the promise. So to not be dishonest about trust, these are the things that, these are the actions that enables one to earn the nearness of Allah. And the next, the third matter was to treat their neighbors well. And this has been mentioned in many traditions that if one has extra food in the home, one should actually make some extra food and give it to one's neighbors, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims, whether they are related or not related to us. In fact, sometimes there are such good relations. When one treats them in such a good way, they can become closer to us than even other Muslims can become. So this is the third piece of advice the Holy Prophet ﷺ gave, apart from the first two, that you should always treat neighbors well, along with always speak the truth and fulfill one's trusts completely and properly. So, and in this one, the good treatment of neighbors has got many different examples. To help someone at their time of need, to be sympathetic towards them, sometimes invite them to your home, or sometimes give them some kind of a gift. So in this way, there are many ways in which one can treat our neighbors well. The circle of this is vast, and in this tradition, such a believer who does this and who treats his neighbor, whether he is Muslim or not, whether they are related or not related, no matter who it is, if it's a neighbor, then you should treat them well. And this enables one to attain such great treasures, and one can gain those attributes and those blessings which enable us to attain the nearness and the love of Allah. So we should therefore always take care to act in accordance with these blessed instructions. JazakAllah. Assalamu alaikum.